So now we go to integration. So we'll do numerical integration. So we'll be given n points. Okay. So we have x-axis. So we have x0 to xn minus 1 and values of the function at these points. So this is a common theme. Interpolation, we had n points given, xi's and yi's, and I try to fit a function. So please note that interpolation, I don't mean to find a value at a given point, any non-given, not given point which is not given, but I can give the full function and using which you can find at any place you like. So that's the whole idea. So I am giving you a function which will go through all those points. So integration, also we have all these y's. So this is y0, y1. So some curve will go through this. So of course this curve I need to interpolate. And once I interpolate the curve, then I can find out integration. Okay, so if I have f of x, I can integrate. The technology is bit in several steps, and there's many methods to integrate. So I'll cover two. So this is called Newton Cotes. Again, these are same Newton. Okay, Newton Cotes method, and the second one will be Gaussian quadrature. In fact, so these methods are classified into two class, called simple method. Well, it's easy to see simple method and complex method. So in simple method, okay, there are some notation here. So xi's are called abscissa. Abscissa spelling. SSA, okay. Now I'm going to approximate the integral. So we have finally the formula. Whatever derivation you do, the formula for the integral. So I go from, we call this point A and point B. Okay, so end points are A and B. So integral AB fx dx is approximated by a polynomial px dx, and this is going to be written for all the, this is a notation, okay, so the standard notation which we follow, equal to wi fxi. So these xi's are abscissas and these wi's are called weights. So this function is known to me, these are all yi's, and just multiply by wi and then I get the integral. So of course the problem, our objective is to compute wi's, give you wi's. So in simple methods, xi's are linearly spaced, they are given to you, and you compute wi's. So that will be part of Newton Cotes. But in complex method, Gaussian quadrature, xi's are not known. In fact, you get xi's so that your integral is accurate, best accurate possible. So here, in this case, compute both wi and xi, so that your error is least. So this is more complicated, that's why it's called complex method, but it's really good. Okay, so it gives you very accurate results. This is not so accurate, so we'll cover first, which is simpler, Newton Cotes. So idea is quite simple. So let's see, I need to get this px, which is approximation of fx. So px will apply Legendre polynomial, Legendre interpolation, which goes through all the n points. So we already done this. So that is why you'll find that interpolation using which we can derive lot of numerical schemes. That's why it's called mother of, well, I won't say all, but lot of numerical schemes. So we write this as J, Lj, X, and Yj. So this is function of X. Of course, it involves also Xi. But there is no Y dependence. So once I fix X's, then this is independent of Y's. Now to get the integral, so I want I, approximate I, so integral px dx. So my notation is slightly changing, I and j, so please don't mind, okay. So ij is running index. So the integral, so I'll put a to b, endpoints. So this will act only on lj. It can't act, well, y is a constant. So I can say yj outside, some more j's, integral ljx dx a to b. Now this can be computed given xi's. Given abscissas, you can compute this. And so this yj, and notation is called cj. With, so how many points are you using for abscissa? So minimum I need 2 points. So there's no intermediate point, it's just A and B. So the minimum will be, so let me just draw it here. A and B. So value of the functions are given here. So that's the lowest order. So it will give a linear interpolating function. So next would be, I give you 3 points. So there'll be a point in between A and B. So there's A, B, and there's something in between. Linear space means it's going to be midway. So I give 3 points like this, or 4 points. So for all these points, there's a, you need to give your C's, CI's, this CJ. So I need to specify how many points are you using. So that's why there's a notation called n. So for this n is 2, for this n is 3, and we can have n equal 4. So more points you take, more accurate that will be. Okay, so we need to integrate this. Now let's do some trivial functions. N equal to 2. So n equal to 2, what is my fx, lj? So let's look at px. So px will be, so in fact we did this before. So x minus a, so the next point b minus a, this will be f of a, no, f of b. So if I put x equal to b, then I get f of b, and then I get x minus b, a minus b. So this is a formula of Lagrange interpolation. Now, so these are LJs, two of them. So I need to integrate this. So that will give me two coefficients, which will multiply at FA and FB. So integral of this is X minus A, B minus A dx, A to B. So this is straightforward, no? So 1 by b minus a, so b minus a whole squared by 2. I made one mistake. So this multiplied by b minus a. Okay, so this is a multiplication of b minus a. So c's are, the dependence on b minus a is less on c's. So there is a b minus a factor. So this is b minus a by 2. Implies what is c corresponding to this? Half. So c corresponding to point b is half. Similarly, you can compute. This is just algebra. C corresponding to A is also half, for n equal to 2. So what is the answer for integral formula for n equal to 2? So it is B minus A half y A plus half y. Okay. So this, what is it called? You might have heard this. This trapezoid rule. In fact, the area, this is the area. So this is called trapezoid rule. We can also do for n equal to 3, there is a Simpson rule. So n equal to 3 has 3 coefficients, and n equal to 4 has 4 coefficients, and so on. Okay. So I am going to run the code, actually I will use SymPy. Well, I hope you want to learn it. So symbolic manipulation, I can do integral exactly. It won't be numerical integration, but this integration can be done exactly because A, B are symbols, and I'll get half, exact half. Okay, so I'll show you how to use SymPy. But let's, before going into that, so this is a formula for arbitrary n. Okay, this is called Newton-Gotz method. So your objective is compute this. Now, what is the error? So we should also be able to find out what the error is, formula for the error. So how do I estimate error? So I'm going to erase this part. So table I'll show you. So once I start the computer, I'll show you the table where C's are nicely tabulated. You don't need to compute, you just take from the table. Well, you compute once. I would say that you should compute once. But then after that, take from the table. So how do I estimate error? So we already done the error for Legendre polynomial. So remember the error? Yes. This is analytically doable. Well, which order you want? I mean, the computer will do for 50th orders. It'll do, in fact, computer will do it. It'll take longer time. It can do 100th problem. Symbolic. So I'll show you how to do it. Okay, that is not numerical. That is like Mathematica, symbolic manipulation. Actually, no. Look. Here polynomials can be integrated, so these are polynomials. So polynomials can be integrated analytically. These are polynomials, so integration is possible. Okay, so error I estimate by what is the error in the Legendre polynomial itself. So what is fx minus px, which is error, efx, we said is 1 over n factorial. Fn zeta, zeta lies between A and B. We don't know what zeta is, but zeta is a point in between. Product x minus xi. I goes from 0 to n minus 1. Okay, so this is the error in the function. We don't know zeta, but zeta lies in between. Okay, so how do I estimate the error? So I wanted fx dx. But I computed px dx. So error is basically integral of ex dx. So error is integral a to b ex dx. So this is a number. We don't know zeta, but we can make an estimate what is it, this number, upper bound on it. But this is doable. This integral again computer will do it. So I can do 1 over n factorial fn zeta. And integral of this, so there's error. But there is a little bit of catch. When I once I do it, I have done this integral. So if there are only two points, then error is finite, because this function will be. So what is this function will be? For two points, is product of. For n equal to 2, let's write n equal to 2. My function with this guy will be x minus a, x minus b. So this 0 at both ends, but it's quadratic in between. So this function looks like that. So area under curve is finite. Okay, so that is this non-zero value. But for n equal to 3, you get, so in fact this is the midpoint. So x minus a, x minus mid, x minus b. This will have behavior like this. And it turns out it becomes 0, which is good actually. Why is it good? Yeah, so my error at that order is 0. But I can't say my error is 0. I have to go to higher order. So error is higher order. So just to, so I will give you the table, okay. So this will, the computer will do all the computation. For this error is of the order h cube. And h is b minus a, h cube. So you can just do the algebra, it's h cube. But for this error is h5, not h4. Because h4 is 0, it goes higher order. So it gives you much better accuracy. So you choose n odd points. So the one, the first, so well, I will approximate, if this is giving you 0, well I say, well the fx, you have to keep the polynomial of the next order in that computation. And then that I will do is, so I multiply this by taking a point outside. I take a point outside and make a polynomial go through this, but integral only from here to here. So ex is integrated from a to b, but my polynomial is a higher order polynomial. And that gives you non-zero error. So this error, I mean I'm not going to do the algebra here, but error is less for n odd. Okay. So now let's, so is that clear? The idea is clear for all of you. Now I will show you two codes, one how to compute this CIs, and second just do Newton codes by various orders. So which one should I do first?
CI.
CI? Okay. Now literally let's do the other one, because CI has some new concepts. So Newton codes, given CIs, I will show you how to compute, I mean this is straightforward, but just the code, you should go through the code and how to compute the error. Okay, so before we go there, I'll just show you the table. So this is a table given in any book. Okay. So how do I get the coefficients? So coefficient is obtained by, so divide each of these numbers by n, capital N. So it's going to be 1 by 2, 1 by 2. For n equal to 2, number of points. If number of points is 3, then it's going to be 1 by 6, 4 by 6, 1 by 6. It's computed. In fact, I'll show you how to compute them by SymPy. So for n equal to 4, the leftmost point is 1 by 8, the two midpoints are 3 by 8, 3 by 8 each, and the last point is 1 by 8. Okay, this is symmetric. You see that is symmetric. So these are the table given to you. So you don't need to compute from scratch. And what's the error? So is that clear? So this is up to seventh order. You can compute higher order. I mean, this will be not a problem. So error for 2 points, error is h cube. And the zeta, f3 zeta, third derivative of zeta. But this will always put a bound, lower and upper bound. I did that for exponential. So this is always, we don't compute zeta. I mean, that's insane. You don't want to compute zeta. And so it's order h cube. P3 is order h5. I'm not sure you can see this. This order h5. So it jumped by 2. So 3, I should expect it 4. But fourth order is 0. You go order higher. So h is small, supposed to be, h is supposed to be small, so this is more accurate. P4 gives you h5, so p3 and p4 have same accuracy in terms of h. P factor is different, but same accuracy. P5 is again h7, and p6 is again h7. Okay, so these are formulas we can also compute using SymPy. Okay, like the factors 112, 190 is all comes. Okay, so let's see the code. So this is computing at different orders. So this is slightly tiny fonts. So Newton codes, the number of points, the function. I can pass a function as argument, which I'm not sure you may not have done it. You can pass a function as an argument to in Python. So we'll define f, like f is defined here, is sine x. Now this is my definition. This is a lower point, and this is a the minimum x and this max x. Okay, so for second order, this is just a b. For third order, I have to insert a intermediate point. So h is half of b minus a by 2. Well, b half of b minus a. So this is the formula for 2 points. Right, this trapezoid rule. For 3 points, this is again coming straight from the table. 1/6 of the first point, 4/6 of the second point, and 1/6 of the, sorry, not 4/6, yeah, 4/6. Third is 1/6 again, and multiply by b minus a always. So these all multiply by b minus a, and these are all taken from the table. Is it clear how to write the formula? So every point you multiply ci's. And multiply by b minus a at the end. So if I so this will give you, give me function, give me the endpoints, and give me the number of points you want to use. So you give me a and b, you don't give me the intermediate point. I will compute it. It's linear, linearly spaced. Okay. So if we run it, so this part is running the code. So max order is 6. So I go up to 6th order, I integrate it, so and put the value in integ. An error is here, from j going to 2 to 6 range, actually it will go up to 2 to 5 in fact, right, it won't, range will take up to only 5, range is last minus 1. So Newton codes, I invoke the formula, the function, and error is computed as this, it's absolute, you just take the absolute of this. And I print it. I also plot it. So so remember, I need at least 2 points. So I should not plot for point 1 or point 0, because they are all zeros, and they are plot in log scale, because things are, error is falling kind of exponentially. So I am putting log scale, and this is 2 to max order. So it will go to max order minus 1. Right, is range, I'm using range, and this error up to this again is max order minus 1, the last point is max order minus 1. Okay, this is a standard, you understand, where is x order minus 1, right? So if I say array of size array 5, then the last one is has index 4, so that's the last index is 4. Okay, so I put the label. So so if you just run this, so shall I run it, or I can show you the figure plot? So okay, let's run it. It'll give two plots, but first let me just run this. So it's giving you, okay, this is a, no, actually, this is figure 2. They're running two of them. So this error. So this for n equal to 2, error is of the 0.1. So this sine function, 0 to pi by 2. Answer is 1, right? Integral sine x dx. And the error is 0.1, which is 10%, which is significant. But then it has come down to just taking 3 points. Error is it is 10 minus 3, so which is 0.1%. And 3 to 4, error didn't decrease much. So every odd point, the error decreases rapidly. So you should use odd number of points. And at 5, error again decreases. 6, it won't be decrease much. And at 7, it will decrease again. Okay, so we can compute error. Now, suppose I have a function a and b are far apart, a and b are not close by, they're far apart. So my function may be reasonably like this. If you use trapezoid rule, this is bad. Right? You should not use. If you use higher order, it may capture. Intermediate, well, I mean, it may capture intermediate, but this actually you should do. What should I do here? I should not use just 2 points. The idea is to make further divisions, and each of this part I apply Newton codes. So that's the idea. So you should apply Newton codes at each of the intermediate, each of the small slices. So I made many slices. So I have one example where I can just apply trapezoid rule for with different many slices. So suppose we have m slices. Okay. So I'm going to apply only trapezoid rule. This is simple to illustrate. You can also use the higher order. Of course, I am assuming that a function can be computed at all these points. Okay, is that clear? So I am going to do trapezoid here, trapezoid here, trapezoid here, trapezoid here. So this is point A and B, but I have intermediate points. So actually, if you may call, this is B, then this is again AB like this. This is what I am trying to do. So this is x0 and this is xn minus 1. So trapezoid rule will give you what? The first integral will give you x0 plus x1 by 2. Not function, not x0. Half multiplied by this h, not b minus a. So h. Then same thing I'll get for fx1. I'm going to make a shorthand fx2, like this. So it's a sum of trapezoidal sums of each segment, each slice. But if you see, fx1 can be added from here and here. So all the intermediate points you can add half plus half. So this involves how many multiplication and addition? It involves 2 addition for each slice. I can decrease the order. I can write this as sum fxi's. So sum over all, because all of them are 1, because there is half contribution from the left and half contribution from the right. But at the end points factor is half. Right? So what I should do, I just sum it up minus half at f0. Plus fn minus 1. This is cheaper, right? I mean, I don't have to do n sums. I just, sorry, 2n sums. I just do n sums and subtract one number here. Okay? So these kind of tricks one can use and one should use. So that is a part shown here as well. So if this is quite common. that you do Trapezoid rule for many slices or Simpson rule for many slices. So this integration part is given here. So Newton quotes 2, but for 2, but I do for n points. So this is, so I have to compute h, which is b minus a, so I'm, there are n minus 1 slices, and then I do this sum, so I'm just doing this sum, and finally subtract half of the n points. So this will give me the answer for different h. So this is what is done here. Yeah, max number of points is 10, then this sum is straightforward, okay. So I get for different h. So first time h is big, which is pi by 2. The next time is h is pi by 2, pi by 4. Then pi by 8, no, not pi by 8, pi by 6. So I just keep dividing, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4. So that was the other plot which we saw. So how, so question is, how does error decrease with h? I am making small and small slices. So we know the answer, no? I told you the answer. How does error decrease with h? Who said h cube? Error decreases h cube, and so this is h cube. So this for h, which is largest h, this one, then I decrease h by 2. This h by 3, h by 4, h by 5, like this, and this line is cube, h cube. So I'm going to finer and finer h, and my error is decreasing. 10 power minus, well, I mean, something like, so you know how to read this off? What is this value, this value? You see the ticks? So what's the value, tell me? This is, this value is how much, y-axis? 0.01. What does this tick correspond to? This one. 0.02. Okay, so you should know how to read the log scale. Next is 0.03. This 0.04. They are not linearly spaced because it's log scale. Okay, and when you're plotting them, so this is 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like this. Okay, so this is h cube. So it is going like h cube, you can say. Okay, so I have 10 minutes to briefly introduce the SymPy. So SymPy, let's just do one or two functions. So I'll just do one, this will be quick, okay, I mean, I have 10 minutes. So first import, import SymPy. Or from SymPy import SYM for symbolic. Now here I have to define which are symbols and which are numbers. Well, you don't define which are numbers, numbers are already known. Symbols you have to define, which are symbols. And it's defined as, so let's say I want to use X as a symbol. So say X equal to symbols. And what are you going to use in your code, in your program? So I'm going to say x, I'm going to use x itself. But x will not be evaluated. X, it, computer knows that it is a symbol. So I put in single quotes. So this tells that x is a symbol. Okay. So enter. Actually, no, let's do one thing. Because I have to say SymPy dot symbols, no? That's what I, okay? So I won't avoid that. So it's, so X is symbol. Now you want to, sorry?
star means all.
All.
Okay. So you want to integrate. So actually SymPy has a very good documentation. You can just download the PDF file. So SymPy documentation, if you say, you'll get the full documentation. But I want to do integration. So integrate. So integrate x. So you know, let's say x squared. So I want to integrate with x itself. So it will do the symbolic integration x cube by 3. Okay. So it just, so this is, it assumes that it is x is symbol and it will do it. I want to do within a bound. So if you want to do within a bound, so you say x lower bound and upper bound. It will give you exact number. It is not going to do numerical integration. It gives just exact integration and 1/3. Okay. So we will use this feature to do our computation of CIs. So is it clear? I mean, this is quite simple. You just have to specify the symbols and you just have to do it. That's. So it can do a lot of stuff. I mean, this is really fancy. You can just differentiate, you can do vector calculus, derivative, gradient, all of it. Okay. Where is my? Okay, so you have to see this code quite carefully. So first start, I want to declare what are my symbols. So I have quite a few symbols, so you can do in one shot. So symbol within argument, you have to put within a small bracket argument, small brackets. So x, a, b, and h, these are my symbols. So n is 3, so I am just choosing 3 points. So my h will be b minus a by n minus 1. So this n is an integer, so the computer knows that part. And I am going to create x arrays where, which will give me the coordinates of the abscissas. X array contains abscissas. So what are they? I just do in a loop. So a plus ih, straightforward, right? So it will be containing symbols, will be a plus h, a plus 2h, da da da, a plus n minus 1h, symbols. Now this is the loop. If you read my code about Legendre polynomial, is exactly I copied from there. So copy paste, okay, there is no shame in copy paste, just copy paste. So n is size of the array. So coefficient, I am going to create. So I'll basically club together in array. So coefficient is an array. So you go in a loop. So I have to, how many elements are there? The coefficients are there. So I have 0 to n minus 1, n of them. And so numerator, this part is common from our earlier code. So so j not equal to y, so this is that Lj. This Lj, I get Lj, symbolic. Then I just integrate it from a to b. Since I have to factor b minus a, so I have to remember there's a b minus a factor. I told that b minus a is outside, so I have to divide by b minus a. And you'd use simplify. If you don't simplify, it's a big expression. And computer also compacts it. It does intelligently compact it, and it gives a number. And I append it to in the loop. So after all this computation, I'll get all the CIs for given n. I can also compute error. So for this factor is x minus xi for all i's. But recall I said for even n that will work. For odd n I have to use the point after b. So this is that condition. So if it is odd or even, you have to do it separately. Okay. So this part, I'm just multiplying by one extra factor. So this works. So is that clear to everybody? So just have to do symbol, and only thing is difference in our earlier coding of Python is this is symbol, and I had to do integration here like this. So let's run it. we have 3 minutes. Is that okay? So I'll share the code. You just have a look and study it. So run Newton codes. So I have to run this function. So let's see. So it has defined the function. So I need to run it. So you can see what is x. X is a symbol. What is h? H is, so I am using n equal to 3. N equal to 3. Yeah, so n is 3. So yeah, 3 minus 2, so that is h. Simplify, so without simplification the function is long one. It has a cube, b cube, all that. So it will try to, so what is a minus b squared? So a squared plus b squared minus 2ab. So it will compact it. It will divide it. So it will do some more simplification. So that is h. For 3 points, so I basically I need the midpoint, right? When this is the midpoint, so this is h. Okay, so I need the answer. So Newton codes, coefficients. So it will return what? It returns both coefficients as well as error factor. So x array is already there, so you just need to call x array is this for 3 points. So Newton codes. Okay. So these are the answers. So my coefficients are 1/6, 2/3, which is 4/6, and 1/6, and error is minus 1/90. So I divide by already h5. I divide by h5. You look at the error part, so there is a division. Okay, so it works. So you look at the table, this is exactly same number. You can increase n or decrease n, let's decrease n. And error is minus 1/12 h cube. So I need to run again. So this is my answer, okay? So half coefficient, and error is minus 1/12 h cube. So you can put n equal to 4. So it will work for all of them. So you just can create this. Okay. So you get it, okay? So you work, play around with this. SymPy is slightly, you have to just be used to it. Okay, thanks.